The Mercedes-Benz EQS has been making waves in the automotive world by having the lowest drag coefficient out of all production cars. And that's a good thing, because the lower the drag coefficient is, the farther you can travel without having to recharge your car. But why does it have such a low drag coefficient? To find out, we did a simulation of one. And one thing to note is that this model is very close to the real version. There's a few small differences because only Mercedes really has the exact model. This video shows the flow over the car, and the wake is pretty much the red parts at the back. These are the bad parts. Mercedes has been clever though and greatly reduced the back area of the car. That immediately reduces the drag because the wake is much smaller now. Another important point is that at the top of the trunk, there is this small spoiler. It's not very big, but it's there to kick the flow up a little bit and increase the downforce on the rear wheels. Doing this actually increases the drag, but it's necessary to keep the car stable at higher speeds. At the back, these lines show several small vortices forming, and they are a lot smaller than what you find on most cars. And from this angle, we get a good appreciation of just how small the wake is, because it's like literally half a car length downstream, and the wake has already died out. That's impressive. In addition to that, it's important to note that the velocity deficit in the wake isn't that great either. I mean, the regions of really red parts are relatively small. Another important point is that at the front of the car, there's almost no red flow. And the reason why we would get red flow here is because this is where slowing flow occurs. And that's because the flow hits the car and slows down. That increases the pressure at the front and then the drag. From this angle, we see that there is some red, but not that much. And looking at the pressure, there is some high pressure, but not that much either. So what Mercedes has done is reduce the area of the front face and then reduce the area of the back face. We don't get as much resulting force and hence reduce the drag. Impressively, looking on from the top, the flow that is shed off the back is very steady. In most cars, the wake moves from side to side and quite violently. But Mercedes has greatly reduced that motion, which also reduces the drag because in part, it reduces the amount of rear area that is exposed to a wake and lower pressure. So looking at all these drag reductions, it's not that surprising that the EQS has such a low drag coefficient and is only 0.2.